Hi, my name's Peter. I'm going to take you for a run around Paris on a very early summer's day in early July 2024. I'm starting from my hotel, which is in the Montmartre area, pretty close to Moulin Rouge and also to Sacre Bleu. This is the highest point of Paris, so I'm going to start by running down the long hill. You can see the topography on top of the screen. It starts with a hill and I'm heading towards the Seine River, and I'm just going to basically find my way down there randomly, see if I can see some sights along the way. You'll probably see that I did get to the Arc de Triomphe, and then try to find my way back to my hotel, which is pretty easy these days because of all of the smartphone technology with mapping and things like that. Now, I just ran past a square called Pigalle Square, and you might be wondering why I've made this video. It's really made for people running on treadmills, so that they've got something to look at rather than looking at a blank screen. I do this myself quite a lot, and I think it's fantastic. All the people that post videos of cities from all around the world, so this is a little contribution. Most of the time, the runs that I do are running around Chinese cities. This is my first one in Europe. The first time I've actually been to Europe. So that's the main reason this is made. Of course, you can also use this video for just checking out Paris. You're very welcome to do that. What I would advise if you're on a treadmill running, rather than my voice annoying you, you might want to turn the volume down and put some headphones on and just listen to music. That's what I do when I'm doing it as well. Now, what you might notice is some cutscenes there. There's some blending. The image looks like it's been edited. It has been edited, and that's because when I go through an intersection, I normally need to look left and right, and it's really messy, so I just cut those out. There was another one. Okay, that's the reason for that. You might also notice that the screen has got some instruments over it. The top is the topography. You can see the hills. I'm running down a hill right now. On the top right-hand corner is a map of exactly where I'm going and what direction I'm going to. You can see the little turquoise colored arrow showing which direction I'm going. And on the left-hand side, the top left, is the how long I've run for, how far I've gone, what my pace is, that's minutes per kilometer, and what my current heart rate is. Sorry, excuse me, I did a burp then. That was while I was running. Another thing you might have noticed is I'm running actually pretty quick, quicker than normal. My normal running speed is about 4.5 minutes per kilometer, or even 5 minutes per kilometer. So to be less than 4 minutes per kilometer is pretty amazing. Even though this is a downhill, I don't normally run this fast, even downhills like this. Part of that might be because the running conditions are excellent. The temperature was about 22 degrees with a low humidity of about 50%. And what I'm used to back home, I live in China, in Shenzhen, next to Hong Kong, is this time of the year especially, the running conditions are between 30 and 35 degrees with a humidity of about 80%, so it's very hot and sweaty. So yeah, this is amazing for me. I love this, these conditions. Now I'm just coming up to a tiny little park. These little parks are all over the city. This one is called the Square d'Estien d'Orbes, and I'm sure I've pronounced that terribly, but anyway, that's as close as I can get to it with my terrible French. I've got a very limited French of bonjour, which is a magic golden word. I tried to use that with everybody that I ever met, and it makes a huge difference. Okay,
sorry.
Change directions, and I nearly got hit by a car then, and said sorry to her, and keep moving. there are some nice loud motorbikes here. I'm not used to this sound very much living in China, because almost all of the motorbikes in the city that I'm living in Shenzhen, they've been petrol motorbikes have been completely replaced by electric bikes. So there's literally millions of electric motorbikes in Shenzhen, but it's very rare to hear a petrol bike like that. This corner coming up is a big department store area. I'm not sure, there's a Dr. Martens shop. I'm not sure what this is actually called, but you can see it's got a very baroque, kind of a city square sort of attitude. That's a metro station. I'm not sure which metro it is, but there's a lot that happens here. It's still pretty quiet. I took to the bike lane here because the streets were getting a little bit too crowded. There's a double, pretty cool bus. And yeah, just kept going from there. I did cross the road here where I found a safe spot and kept moving. Noticing more and more people out on the street. A lot of these are tourists. Of course, Paris is one of the biggest tourist cities in the world. And yeah, I can see more and more people out on the street taking photos and things. I guess just getting out early, trying to beat the crowds, beat the lines. Lots of things have got big lines and things like that. So yeah, it's not surprising. I'll just run along here quietly for a while until I come to the next thing. The next thing is a really big old looking, I'm not sure what it was when I was running, a temple of some kind. It looked like a Roman temple. It actually is a church, and it's made in a Greek temple style. I'm not sure what denomination is. I guess it's a Christian church. It's called, and again I'm going to butcher the name of it, Église de la Madeleine. Okay, so yeah, it's a huge, I didn't go inside it. I didn't get a chance to go inside it the whole time. But in this run, I just ran around it and kept going. There's all lots of these kinds of things in Paris. It's impossible to see them all. Just jump over this little barrier. Now this is the start of the Olympic area. This is 2024 that this video was filmed, which is of course the Olympic year for Paris. And I was here a couple of weeks before the Olympics started, so some of the streets are starting to be closed up already, which is fine. I could still get around most places. And in places like this, it was cool because I had the road to myself, as you can see here. But other places, I was blocked from getting through as well. But anyway, it was okay. you might see a tiny little line in the distance in front of this street. That's an Egyptian obelisk. It's called the Place de la Concorde. And just, yeah, I'm not going to go right up to it. I'll turn the corner here. But it's one of the ancient artifacts that Paris has got from the ancient world. Of course, there's some political debate about that sort of thing, which I'm not going to get into. So, yeah, let's get back to running. Now, I didn't go straight to the river. I saw this park and I thought that looks pretty good, so I turned left and went down it. It's called Jardins des Champs d'Elysées. Sorry. And this leads to what we'll see in a second. But yeah, it was a nice park. Lots of people out here. A lot more than I was expecting. And it has got the very typical Parisian gravel surface. There's not a lot of grass here. There's a lot of gravel in their parklands. Oh, a lot of trees, lots of gravel. And that opens up to, I'm now on the Champs-Élysées. I should know this from watching the Tour de France so many times. I'm a cycling, you know, nut, and I've seen the finish of the Tour de France quite a few times. So yeah, and it's really great to be now running on this very, very famous boulevard. I'm heading towards the Arc de Triomphe. It's way in the distance, as you might be able to just see at the top of the screen. My speed here is still actually pretty quick. This is 4 minutes 15 is pretty much smack bang on 3-hour marathon pace. For those of you who are runners will know that that's kind of a benchmark for a pretty good marathon time. So yeah, of course this is not a marathon distance. I'm only running about 10k or 10 or 11 kilometers. But yeah, it's still good to be doing that speed. See from the topography map at the top, this is the start of a pretty long uphill. It's not steep, it's certainly pretty easy hill, but it goes for about 1.2 kilometers right up until I get to the Arc de Triomphe. So yeah, and you can see lots more barriers being put into place. There's definitely lots going on here. Going past a pretty major intersection. This is called the Franklin D. Roosevelt area. There's a metro station here as well. You might be wondering, why is there an area of Paris called Franklin D. Roosevelt? What's his connection with Paris? The connection is that after World War II, in 1946, when Paris was liberated from the Nazis, as a gift to the president, who Franklin D. Roosevelt was the president of the US, of course, at the end of World War II, and the French people, there was a French government, named this area of the Champs-Élysées. Still don't get it right. are named after him, and that's of course in contrast to the very famous photos of earlier in the war where Hitler was standing under the Arc of the Triumph. So yeah, a bit of history. One thing I hope you can notice as well is how clean Paris is. You hear all of these false claims that Paris is a very dirty city. I didn't find that at all. There's a little bit of rubbish around, but absolutely not a problem. It's certainly not as clean as Kyoto in Japan, but in terms of a capital city compared to certainly where I live in China, but also Melbourne and other places like that too, Paris is a very clean city. There's lots of bins here. So yeah, there's lots of places for people to look after their, get rid of their trash. This area, just before you get to the Arc de Triomphe on this part of the boulevard, is a pretty high-end clothing area. All of the Chanels and the Diors and all of those kinds of shops are here. You can see watch companies and things like that, Rolex would be here. That's not to say this is the only part of Paris that will have expensive clothes. As you'll know, Paris is one of the fashion capitals of the world, and there's various areas of Paris that will have this kind of thing, even Adidas. But yeah, this is certainly one of those places. Lots of people around here having breakfast. There's metro stations here. This is a bit of a getting off point for the Arc de Triomphe as well. You'll notice my speed has slowed a little. It's more like 4.5 minutes per kilometer, or even 4:40 there or so. That's actually more my normal speed. So yeah, this hill is slowly starting to wear me down, but that's okay. That's, you know, I was very happy with how I was feeling, and yeah, it was all good. Just weaving and winding around in between people and onto the bike lane. Oh, there's the Arc again, and yeah. It was good, very good place to run. I followed this woman. I wasn't trying to follow her, but we just kind of were going at a similar pace for the whole way between here and the top of the hill. You'll see her again later. Okay, so I'll say goodbye to my traveling companion there. She goes one way, I go another. And And I'm in the at the Arc de Triomphe pretty much now. Another history lesson, which I think is right. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. This was ordered to be built by Napoleon as part of the Napoleonic Wars. I might be wrong there. So yeah, and this is obviously one of the iconic parts of Paris, one of the big 5 or 10 attractions kind of thing. So I'm happy to have gotten here on my exploring run. I'm going to run around the whole perimeter so you can sort of see the area, and then I'm going to head back down to the river. So I'm almost around the whole place now. As you can see, it's a huge park. It's not just the Arc de Triomphe in the middle of traffic. They've actually got a lot of open space around too, and of course a lot of gravel. I'm surprised there's not more grass in Paris, but it's really not a problem. Feel bad. The gravel's still actually pretty good. So yeah, I'm going. Oop, excuse me, again. And this was a pretty nice area, certainly a great area for running, and it's pretty quiet. You can see there's a big shoulder area there for parking and service road. So yeah, I'm far away from the traffic. I think it's a pretty expensive area, but there's not many shops here either, so I didn't come back to this place. It's kind of on the way, it's halfway between the Arc de Triomphe and the Eiffel Tower. So I'm almost at the peak of the hill, and then I'll start heading back down. Downhill. So yeah, and how's my speed going? Yeah, it's still about 4.5 minutes per kilometer. I think I cross here and yeah, start heading down soon. Okay, so the downhill starts. This was good fun, and my speed picked up a little bit again. I'm on about 3-hour marathon pace again, which is always fun. And yeah, it's all good. A lot of cafes here have got, you saw back there, they can put their tables and chairs out into the car park areas. Now I see that all over Paris. It's actually pretty cool. So yeah, it's a nice place. I'm just going to run again without talking for a while until I get to the bottom of this hill. Okay. Thank you. Okay, finally at the bottom and at the river. You can't quite see it yet. You can also notice that the map and the video is slightly out of sync. I hope that's not a problem for you. It's not for me. It certainly still does the same purpose as far as running on a treadmill is concerned. And this surprised me. I wasn't actually expecting. I should have known the Eiffel Tower was in view there. So yeah, there's the Eiffel Tower. I didn't stop there for too long. I needed to get back to the hotel. Oops, ran across the traffic a little bit there. So that's all I see. I don't run under it in this run. I'm now heading back towards the Louvre. Yeah, along the river itself, so I'm going to run along the river for a while now. So here's the river Seine, the Seine River. I'm running on the gravel, as you can see. There is some grass here. I didn't go down to the actual water itself because I just wanted a bit more of a broad view of everything. Almost hit those birds. But yeah, you can see the river there. And they're trying to clean it up so that it can be used in the Olympics for their marathon swim, I think. I'm not sure, and their triathlon. I'm not sure whether they were able to do that. But yeah, we'll see soon. If you're watching this after the Olympics, of course, you will have known this already.
I'm GoPro-ing it, but the traffic's bad because there's a lot of things shut down because of the Olympics.
To my right is a park at the Grand Palais. There's lots of fences here, as you can see. That's very closed. I don't think it's just for the Olympics that it's closed. I think they're renovating the whole place, so I couldn't get through there at all, which was fine. I needed to start heading north anyway, so I'm going back. Towards trying to speak some French there. Didn't seem to make much difference. So yeah, I'm heading back towards, I'll go past Franklin D. Roosevelt again soon. So now I'm back at Franklin D. Roosevelt intersection and metro station. And by this time, you can see I've done 7.5 kilometres. My goal was to do about 8, and I knew that I was at least another 2 or 3 kilometres from the hotel. So my focus by now is there's some police. I didn't see many police the whole time in Paris. My focus by now was to just get back to the hotel. So I'm trying to make a beeline. I did get a little bit lost up here as well, but it wasn't anything, you know, certainly not a problem or anything like that, as you'll see. Here's where I started to really get lost. I wasn't sure. I was having some issues with my phone. My hands were pretty sweaty by now, and it was hard to use my phone, and I took some wrong turns. But, you know, I thought I was heading more directly straight to the hotel, but in fact I was heading more due north. But anyway, it's okay. It's a nice area. It was certainly not a problem or anything like that, and I wasn't far off anyway, so it was all cool. Believe how good the traffic was. You know, it's really easy. Paris is such an easy, good city to run around, as you can see. And even though this is early in the morning, so the traffic from cars and pedestrians is less than what it was, you know, would be later on. It still wasn't bad later on anyway. So yeah, it's a fantastic city to run in from that point of view. My speed is too quick. What am I doing? I'm almost 4 minutes a kilometre going up the hill. It's really surprising. It's good. I'm happy to have had that speed. You know, it's almost a speed session. So, yeah, happy with that. It's good. I'm going to stop talking and run a bit longer there. now the uphill's starting to get to me a bit, to back to 4:30 pace, which is perfect. I'm very happy with seeing that, those numbers. But yeah, it's always a little bit hard to do the last part of a run uphill the whole way, but anyway, it's okay. I've got to cross the road here, and I had to wait there for quite a while actually. Anyway, back going again now. I'm nearly at the point where I can start turning right to be east northeast.
Excuse me, Matt. Thank you.
More breakfast time here. I hadn't eaten by this stage, of course. All I had before the run was the quick water. I was starting to get a little bit hungry. Ended up having a very good breakfast in Montmartre. One of the best breakfasts that I was with my girlfriend for the trip around Europe for the whole time. So yeah, it was excellent. Not expensive and very good. Some croissants and very good coffee. Now I'm just about to turn onto a promenade here. I'm going to cross the road and get into the center of it. After this switch, there it is. And these are one of my favorite parts of Paris. These are amazingly good. It's in the center of the two roads, one road going one way and one road the other. You can see how this is well set up, of a bike lane, a pedestrian lane, and just the sitting areas. Again, there's no grass, lots of trees, no grass. I guess it's for saving water, really. this is an amazing place to run. Not having to worry about traffic or anything else like that. Very well organized. Another important point for me here is just how polite everybody is and how well disciplined they are to stay in their areas. As you know by now, I live in China, and the Chinese government is putting these kinds of things in place as many areas as they can. But there's a lack of education, and with that lack of education, the people kind of mess it up because the pedestrians walk where the bikes should be, and the bikes then need to be get sick of trying to weave around the pedestrians, so then they ride in the places that are set for the pedestrians, and it just mixes up and everybody's in each other's way. So it was really, really great to be in a place like this where everybody's just in the right place for their purpose, and there's no hassles for anyone. I was loving it. there was a pretty big roadwork here that I ended up getting messing up and going the wrong way, and kind of ending up, you'll see ahead, I'll keep talking this through, went up here not knowing what was coming ahead, had to go left around there, and I thought I'll just duck across into the road traffic, and then realize once I was out there that I couldn't do that, so needed to try to get back to the footpath and all that. It was fine, nobody was, you know, there was no hassles or anything like that, but I just, yeah, I was in the wrong place, so I went across here and needed to stay on the side footpath for a while, which was busier. I preferred the center promenade, but anyway, that's what you get with, you know, roadworks, isn't it? And it's even busier here. I wasn't really sure where the best place to be was, so I stayed here, but this is back in Wanmacht, and while it's not as busy as the real downtown area of where the Louvre and all of that, those sort of things are, it's still pretty busy here. So yeah, I needed to weave around quite a lot. But there's a lot of good cafes. It's a pretty cheap area too, by the way, while I'm talking about that. Our hotel room, in US dollars, it was about less than 100 per night, and it was pretty good. There was a bit of a hiccup. They didn't have our, it took them a while to see our, oh, there's an Irish pub. It took them a while to find our booking, so we had to sort of convince them that we had paid money before they'd let us in, but they were okay. They were confused, but very friendly still, so yeah, there was no hassles. Just up here, I'll keep talking, is the Moulin Rouge. Unfortunately, some construction going on with it, so you couldn't see that iconic windmill, but that's the Moulin Rouge right there from the movie, and yeah, just generally, that was, again, this is one of the big iconic, you know, places to sort of see in Paris, so it was cool, and it was about 500 meters from our hotel, so right in our area. Also, please leave a comment if you've got anything to ask or anything about, if you're looking at traveling to Paris and everything. I might be able to give you some advice as well of some things to do and things to watch out for. I found it a pretty safe place, and yeah, but there's still, you know, some things to be a little bit careful around as well. So yeah, happy to help if I can. There now. So if you're still watching at this point, thank you very much. I really enjoyed showing you around Paris. The best thing that you can do to help me out if you're still watching it now is to do that very cheap, easy, I mean free, you know, easy thing of just hitting the like button and subscribe if you could. I've got a lot more. I took about 5 different videos of different cities around Europe. So yeah, to see them, if you subscribe, you can see them coming up. And yeah, hope to see you in the next one. I'm breathing heavier here. What's my pace now? Oh yeah, back to 4 minutes 15, so still good speed. And when you see the McDonald's sign, we went to McDonald's twice, which was pretty crappy, but anyway, just wanted to try it out. That means that we're back to the hotel pretty quickly here. This is back at that square that I went across. There's the Golden Arches. I'll take this corner. Back up my little hill, almost hit the police van or whatever that is, and that's pretty much the end of my first run in Paris. I did one more GoPro run, and yeah, I'll post that when I get a chance as well. So here's the hotel. timing's pretty good, happy with that. And time to have a rest before breakfast and a shower. Okay, see ya.